time for Inside Look at Cheyenne Frontier Days, sponsored by Boot Barn and Halliday Motors.
For well over 100 years, Cheyenne Frontier Days has been celebrating the ways of the Old West. Welcome to an inside look at Cheyenne Frontier Days. I'm your host, Anthony Keith. And if you've never been to CFD, this show will let you know everything you need to know. If you're a vet and you've been 50 plus years, there's plenty of new things going on this year. But first off, I don't look the part. I'm dressed like a city slicker. Kids are gonna make fun of me. We gotta change that. Let's go. Wrangler, the best spot in town to get all your cowboy gear. I'm joined with Pat McGee. She's a manager here. She knows what she's talking about. So if you come into town, speak with Pat. Pat, I need the cowboy up. Show me around.
Yeah, we do. Let's go.
All right, so we're going to start off with jeans.
You bet. We got jeans for slim fit, regular fit, relaxed fit, low rise, high rise, in between rise. We got it all. Then we got shirts, and they come in any color, style.
What about hats?
Hey, we're going to go this way. One of the only stores you'll ever find that has its own room just for hats. We can shape this crown.
Personalize everything.
Personalize.
There's no same, you can have a different cowboy hat even if you go the same style. Yours is gonna be different, unique.
You can make it different from everybody else's.
Along with the hat, some may say the most important part is the boots.
That's right.
And serious cowboy, what would they pick out?
Calf ropers, team ropers, the Bulldoggers, they're all wearing this lower heel.
Lower heel, okay. You know, time comes, people hit here. Just tell me about this store. How did it start?
It's a Western store that has been here since 1940.
Well, you're a big part of CFD, that's for sure. If people want to look the part, they come here. Myself, I'm going to get changed right now. Try to play cowboy. Well, Pat, I feel the part. Do I look the part?
You know, you are getting so close, but you got to buff up a little.
It's so true. It's so true. I need to eat some Wheaties, hit the weights. But thanks so much for showing us around the Wrangler and how much you guys have to offer. If you're from out of town, again, this is the place to hit the Wrangler. It's got everything you need for CFD. Now, the one thing every cowboy needs, the belt buckle. I'm talking merchandise. If you want to brag to your friends, you need one of these. I'm joined by JD, head of merchandise. Just tell me, what do people need to leave with to say they've been here?
Well, the one thing they do need to leave with is the belt buckle, but this is your one-stop shop for all official Cheyenne Frontier Days merchandise. T-shirts, caps, mugs, everything.
All the good stuff, necessities essentially. For the little tykes, this one's perfect. But the big thing is the history behind this stuff, and that's what we're going to talk about right now. Time to go for a trip down memory lane at the Old West Museum. I'm joined by the museum's curator, Mike Castle. Now, Mike, you're passionate about this.
Absolutely.
There's a lot of history in here. Just tell me, what's this museum like? What does it have to offer to people?
Well, this museum is fantastic. We're open during Frontier Days, and we offer people a chance to look at the whole 116 years of the event. What's really neat about this museum is the largest rolling collection of vehicles, horse-drawn vehicles in the world. And what we keep here in Frontier Days are the rarest, the best of the best. And this is something that we really enjoy.
And this place is huge. So we're just going to go on through here.
This museum is the only place in the world where you can talk about the history of our event, Cheyenne Frontier Days. That makes us one of the oldest events in the United States. This is where everybody came from Calgary, Pendleton, all over the United States to find out how to do rodeo. Big, huge, Wild West show. And these guys did it so well that they started creating the rules that all modern rodeo is going by. Thunderbirds are really exciting because they are one of the best precision aerial aerobatic teams anywhere in the world. What's really cool is in 1954, the Thunderbirds flew here for the first time ever. Cheyenne Frontier Days is the very first place that the Thunderbirds performed.
And they've been here every year.
They have been here consistently ever since they've started, and they don't miss it. We're always on their calendar. What we have on display here is we have people from all over the world that have been involved with Cheyenne Frontier Days. We talk to people like Lane Frost, and other people. We've got that in the video as well. So if people are interested to see this young man as he was performing here at Cheyenne Frontier Days, George Michael captured it and we put it on display.
But this was used by Senator Kerry.
So this is the pride and joy.
This is definitely it.
When it gets hot outside, you get a chance to museum. Maybe you get to cool off. Let the kids just let all their energy out right here. This is where all the fun happens.
This is fun. And you have kids that are in rodeo. They might be up there watching the sport. They want to wear the stuff the guys are wearing when they're doing bull riding. They want to actually try out a clown barrel. If they want to come up and do like even their own melodrama on stage or try out a small little carriage where they can pretend that they're crossing the frontier, this is the place to come.
Now, this is just one small room. The tour that we saw was just a sneak peek at the museum. There's so much in this place. It's huge. But now that we've learned about the rodeo and the history of CFD, coming up next, get to live it.
Inside Look at Cheyenne Frontier Days is sponsored by Boot Barn and Halliday Motors.
Good, honest Western values. You'll find them at Boot Barn. From boots and belts to hats and jeans, we've got all the best brands at the lowest prices guaranteed. Like Wrangler Original Fit 13 MWZ jeans, now only $21.99, our everyday low price. And at Boot Barn, we've got the largest selection of styles and sizes, so you're sure to find the perfect jeans that fit both you and your wallet. Boot Barn, America's favorite Western and work store, and a proud sponsor of Cheyenne Frontier Days.
Do you see it?
There it is.
Yeah. Where?
It's getting away.
Where is it?
It's gone.
We'll find it.
Any day can be an adventure. That's why we got a Subaru.
Come on, just
wow. Love wherever the road takes you.
Buy or lease a new Subaru from Halliday Motor Subaru, Westland Road, Motor City, Cheyenne.
Inside Look at Cheyenne Frontier Days is sponsored by Boot Barn and Halliday Motors.
Down in the dirt of the arena, if there's one man that knows everything there is to need to know, it's Scott Sewell. He's been the rodeo contestant chairman for 3 years now. Now, Scott, that's the big thing. 3 years doing this. How much have you loved it?
Oh, all 3 years. It's been a blast, an absolute love of rodeo.
That's the way it should be.
Absolutely.
Well, this year, the new thing, the chutes. Tell me about those.
You know, they're the Cadillac of bucking chutes. We've kind of partnered with Prefert this year for actually 15 years. You're looking at sparkling brand new chutes for the next 15 years. Every 5 years, it's going to be a heck of a good bunch of bucking chutes.
That's nice. They look nice and shiny. I like that feel.
Absolutely.
Well, just tell me, daddy of them all, how did this rodeo earn that title?
You know, longest, biggest, and if you ask me, the best. Hands down, you're going to get the top-notch cowboys, cowgirls, and bucking stock. It's the place to come.
Well, tell me about this stock. For some rodeo fans who've been to plenty of rodeos, what makes this stock different?
You know, we're working this year with Steve Smith, with Smith Pro Rodeo. He's bringing NFR quality horses every day. We're going to have huge bucking stock, huge, mean, surly bulls that are just going to wow the crowd and have a heck of a good show.
Now, right now, it's just quiet. It's peaceful in here. Talk about the environment, that first rodeo, what it's like, what the crowd is like.
Absolutely. It's pulse. You feel it from the ground up. Not only is it warm, but it's hot. It's ready. It's just the excitement. It's awesome.
Well, Scott, I want to thank you so much for joining us on the show.
My pleasure.
Best of luck this year. Love the new shoots. They're looking good. Now, if there's one name every cowboy should know, it's Tuff Hedeman. Coming up next, a one-on-one from Tuff. He's out in Texas. Now, Tuff Hedeman wasn't able to join us in person. He's out in Texas. How's it going, Tuff? First big question for you. You're the president of CBR. Why have the CBR Championships here in Cheyenne?
Well, we were at Cheyenne last year and had a great event, and just the way it falls in our schedule, it just seemed like a perfect fit, and I don't think there's a better place in the world to end your season and to have a championship than Cheyenne.
Great. Well, the daddy of them all. Do you feel like Cheyenne Frontier Days has earned that title?
Absolutely. You know, anytime you talk about rodeo to anybody, whether they're a knowledgeable fan or not, you know, Cheyenne Frontier Days is, you know, it always comes up, and it's definitely the daddy of them all for a reason.
Well, you know Cheyenne Frontier Days better than anybody else. Do you have a favorite memory? What was your favorite moment of CFD?
Well, I won the all-around Cheyenne in 1988, but I never, you know, did all that well in the bull riding up until, you know, 96, at which I won it. And then I came back, well, I guess I was 95 and 96. I won it 2 years in a row, which was a big deal.
And how about that CBR leaderboard right now? Looks like there's a lot of young faces in there, not some big names.
Well, I think it's kind of got a, you know, international feel to it. You know, you got a guy from Mexico that has a chance, Hector Cardona. You've got a guy from Louisiana, which is is kind of its own country, seems like at times. Josh Barentine, and then you got Brazilian Luis Blanco.
Last question, Tuff. 2012, how excited are you for this CFD this year?
Well, this is it. I mean, this is the time of year that we've looked forward to all year. You know, this is the finals. It's a championship, so it's going to be fun.
All right, Tuff. Thank you so much for joining us. You're a great interview.
Yes, sir.
Excited
thank
to see you.
You
out here for CFD. But if you had noticed behind me, got Tom Watson back here working on the wagons. These three right here that you see, they're going to be in the parade. Tom fixed these babies up, so without him, there wouldn't be a parade. But stay tuned, because there's still plenty more coming on the show right after the break.
Inside Look at Cheyenne Frontier Days is sponsored by Boot Barn and Holiday Motors.
Do you see it?
There it is.
Yeah. Where?
It's getting away.
Where is it?
It's gone.
We'll find it.
Any day can be an adventure. That's why we got a Subaru.
Come on, just
wow. Love wherever the road takes you.
Buy or lease a new Subaru from Halliday Motor Subaru, Westland Road, Motor City, Cheyenne.
Good, honest Western values. You'll find them at Boot Barn. From boots and belts to hats and jeans, we've got all the best brands at the lowest prices guaranteed. Like Wrangler Original Fit 13 MWZ jeans, now only $21.99, our everyday low price. And at Boot Barn, we've got the largest selection of styles and sizes, so you're sure to find the perfect jeans that fit both you and your wallet. Boot Barn, America's favorite Western and work store, and a proud sponsor of Cheyenne Frontier Days.
Inside Look at Cheyenne Frontier Days is sponsored by Boot Barn and Halliday Motors.
I am now joined by Pat Moffitt, the Contract Acts chairman. He's got one of the best jobs for chairman, hands down. He brings the talent in, all the bands, so he's the fun guy. Now just tell me, bringing in the bands this year, 2012, tell me about some of the talent we're bringing in.
I tell you what, we got a great show starting out this year. We got Zach Brown back, and we're going to start the show earlier Friday night. Traditionally, we've had a rock act, but this year we're going to have a Zach Fest.
I'm mixing it up a little bit. I like that.
Yeah. We're going to set the stage back in the arena a little bit further. There's going to be a big old party out here with Zach and company. So really looking forward to that. And then we roll into Brad Paisley, the band Perry. I mean, who could say anything about those guys?
Definitely.
I'm hoping he does the water, you know, the song. And
we're all hoping. I got my fingers crossed.
Action, so.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Well, we're on the stage now. Looking back here, this is where it's going to take place. For somebody who's never been here before, you got the party zone down below. That's where the fun happens.
That is.
You got stadium seating in the back. Just tell
Correct.
Me, what makes this venue unique for concerts to take place at?
One, it's outdoors. Not a lot of artists will do outdoor shows, but we have such a great reputation that I've actually been asked if I can come to Cheyenne and play by artists. So that says wonders for our community and for the job all our volunteers do. The other thing is the atmosphere. I mean, it's Americana. It's taking a rodeo during the day or a pancake breakfast, a parade. This year we've got the new kids rodeo, Pee Wee Rodeo, and they do stick ponies and a petting zoo and, you know, Thunderbirds flying over. I mean, there's just something for everybody. Our Old West Museum. And then you come out and see a great, great entertainer.
It's just nonstop fun. From sunrise to sunset,
it is.
You come into the sunset part, bringing these bands in.
You'll sleep in 10 days.
That's awesome. Now, what's your favorite band coming into play?
I grew up with Journey. I might be dating myself
Don't
a little bit.
Don't stop.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. There you
I'm tone deaf. I'm not going to try to sing.
Okay. But I tell you what, I've always been a great big Reba fan. My daughter, you know, when I got on this committee, she's like, Dad, we need Reba. Dad, we need Reba. Dad. So the last 2 years, sorry, Jamie. And this year I finally was able to call her and said, guess what? She goes, what? And I said, I got Reba.
She's got a powerful father. Yeah. That's what matters. Well, one thing, these concerts, they sell out fast, don't they? Should people be worried?
You know, Journey you might be worried about. Zach Brown you might be worried about. But I tell you what, we've always got room for one more down in the party zone.
There we go. That's awesome. Anything else you wanted to add about this year's concerts?
You know, I'm really looking forward to it. It will be my last year, a little bittersweet, but come on out, join me, have some fun, And during the week, my birthday happens, so come on out and have a birthday party with me.
It's going to be the best week ever. We'll make sure the last year's the best. Well, Pat, thanks so much for joining us on the show.
Thank you.
Again, ladies, you have this man to thank for bringing Brad Paisley. So,
don't forget Blake Shelton.
And Blake Shelton.
Yeah, you know.
I don't like pancakes, said no one ever. After a night of concerts, you build up an appetite, and that's what the pancake breakfast is for. I spoke one-on-one with the chairman of the pancake breakfast and the Indian Village. Here's what he had to say. Now one of my favorite topics, pancakes. I'm joined by Craig Alexander. He's in charge of the pancake breakfast and the Indian Village. Craig, this is your first year doing this. How excited are you for it?
It's very exciting. It's a whole different world from being, doing the volunteer stuff and then seeing it from the administration side. It's really an exciting time and watching the whole place kind of gear up and take shape. It's a lot of fun.
Well, where we are right now, it's the Indian Village. For somebody who hasn't been here, what does the Indian Village have to offer?
We offer authentic Native American performances three times a day, and also we have about 24 booths of authentic Native American wares, such as jewelry, leather goods, beads, that sort of thing.
Jumping to another subject, the pancake breakfast. Just tell me, what's the purpose of it? What's it like?
The pancake breakfast is basically designed as an emergency preparedness drill. The Kuehnast assist us with it, do a very good job. It's a way to get out and practice feeding mass people, mass numbers in an emergency type situation.
I didn't even realize that. I thought it was just fun. I mean, anytime pancakes
are
involved.
It is fun. It's pretty amazing. We feed about 27,000 people in 3 days and roughly 2 hours per day. So it's pretty amazing how many pancakes can get served.
That's awesome. Now, this is your first year as a chairman. However, you've been doing this for 8 years. So just tell me, what's your connection to CFD?
Well, it's just, it's one of those things. I'm kind of a short timer when it comes to being here in the grand scheme of things. But I was always kind of told that if you're going to live in a community, you should try to do something to give back to it. And so when I had my boys, we did a lot of scouting, a lot of Boy Scouting type stuff. And when they moved on, it was time to turn interest elsewhere. And so we got involved with this, and it's just been a great opportunity, meet great people, and it's just been overwhelming.
Well, thank you so much for joining us on the show, Craig. Have fun this year, and have a few pancakes for me.
Will do.
I'm now at Volunteer Square. It's the newest addition to CFD, and I'm joined by David Miller, chairman of PR. Now just tell me, why is this here? Why is this such a big deal?
Well, as you know, this doesn't go on without all the help of 2,000 plus volunteers. So we decided to rename this area of the park and named it Volunteer Square at CFD. The amphitheater that we're standing in is obviously the centerpiece of that, but really wanted to honor volunteers both present and past, because Frontier Days just won't happen without them.
They're the backbone. More than 2,000 people helping out is huge.
Exactly.
And another thing, that more free entertainment. Seriously,
exactly.
that's the theme this year, free.
I knew you'd like the price tag on this. Yeah, this amphitheater, we'll have free entertainment here, and this whole area will be a bunch of free stuff. Down the Wild Horse Gulch, where we've also done some modifications, is free. A lot of new kid stuff over there. We'll have a stick rodeo, peewee rodeo, petting zoo, things like that. And then, of course, the Indian Village is also still free. So all that east side of the park, plus this Volunteer Square, all free entertainment.
It's going to be huge, expanding the carnival out here. There's just going to be so much to do. What's your favorite thing to do at CFD?
Well, I like all of it, but the cornerstone's a rodeo, so I've got to catch the rodeos, and then I'm a big country music fan, so I love the night shows as well.
Well, going back on the volunteer idea, because we are at Volunteer Square, mm-hmm. yourself as a chairman, you're volunteering. Just tell me, what does that mean, having the community come together for CFD?
It's very rewarding, I think, all up and down the ranks of volunteers. Obviously, when you are the chairman and serve on the general committee, you get a lot of the accolades, but very rewarding up and down. I grew up here, so this is a dream come true for me.
Definitely, David. Well, hey, thank you so much for joining us on the show. It looks great. Can't wait to see a band up here, the Square Field. But hey, best of luck. Come CFD. All Stay right. tuned, because there's still plenty more to come on the show.
Inside Look at Cheyenne Frontier Days is sponsored by Boot Barn and Halliday Motors.
Good, honest Western values. You'll find them at Boot Barn. From boots and belts to hats and jeans, we've got all the best brands at the lowest prices guaranteed. Like Wrangler Original Fit 13 MWZ jeans, now only $21.99, our everyday low price. And at Boot Barn, we've got the largest selection of styles and sizes, so you're sure to find the perfect jeans that fit both you and your wallet. Boot Barn, America's favorite Western and work store, and a proud sponsor of Cheyenne Frontier Days.
Do you see it?
There it is.
Yeah. Where?
It's getting away.
Where is it?
It's gone.
We'll find it.
Any day can be an adventure. That's why we got a Subaru. Love wherever the road takes you.
Buy or lease a new Subaru from Halliday Motor Subaru, Westland Road, Motor City, Cheyenne.
Inside Look at Cheyenne Frontier Days is sponsored by Boot Barn and Halliday Motors.
I'm now joined by Diane Humphrey, director of the Dandies. You guys are the backbone of the rodeo, essentially. You're ambassadors. Just tell me, what does it mean being the director of these young girls right here?
Well, it's my job to train them to do the different drills and the different formations that we use to display the flags. We also have a traveling team of dandies, and we travel around the Rocky Mountain area. We just returned from Santa Fe, New Mexico. We'll be leaving this next weekend for Cody, Wyoming. And we work at those rodeos. We go there to promote Cheyenne Frontier Days and, of course, the sport of professional rodeo.
Definitely. The performance I just saw must have taken some time. How many hours do these girls train?
Well, we start about the 1st of May, and they come about they come 2 days a week. And we do a few hours every evening. And until they know it pretty well. And as you saw, they're fast learners, good riders, and have excellent
horses. Gotta be good riders and good horses out there too.
Yes.
You guys are ambassadors to the rodeo. What does it mean to be a dandy?
Well, to be a dandy, mainly it's to promote Cheyenne Frontier Days. It's a huge honor. And these girls, they'll carry this for the rest of their lives. They learn poise, they learn how to talk to people. Their riding skills just get better and better. And of course, they're here for the largest outdoor rodeo in the world.
Definitely.
And when they go around promoting Cheyenne Frontier Days, everyone knows them and loves them because they do have a great reputation everywhere. And Cheyenne Frontier Days is the biggest.
It's the daddy of them all, hands down.
You bet.
For all the young girls watching right now, how do you become a dandy? Is there some training? How would a girl at home be able to join them?
Okay, for tryouts, we ask them to come with just a horse that they would use, not some wild horse or something, just one they can use. They need to do a reining pattern, so they do need to know how to ride a little bit. And then we do their commitment is number one, both them and their parents, pretty much. They have to have a huge commitment because their whole summer is taken up for Cheyenne Frontier Days.
You've been doing this for more than 20 years. Tell me about this group specifically. What makes them special?
I think what makes this group special, they're all pretty young. They're a great team. They depend on each other so much, and teamwork is what it's all about. If you're going to do a precision drill in the arena, you need to be able to work together.
And they make it look easy and elegant.
Right.
That's their job. They do a great job of that. You guys are the first thing that people are going to see when they come to the rodeos,
right.
So definitely got to make a big statement. I want to thank you
yes.
so much for joining us on the show,
yes.
Diane. Best
thank
of luck
you.
This CFD and with traveling, because I know that's tons of work.
Yes.
Stay tuned, because there's still more to come up on the show. I'm now joined by the prettiest girls of CFD. I'm a little shy around pretty girls, but right next to me, we've got Miss Frontier, Sammy Joe. To my left, we've got Chloe. She's lady in waiting, so just a matter of time before she's Miss Frontier. Now, ladies, just tell me one unique thing about you guys is you're from Canada,
yes.
You're from England. Just tell me about that.
Oh my goodness, yes. We both traveled the country and landed ourselves in Cheyenne, Wyoming, and are now honored and blessed to be in this prestigious title of Miss Frontier and Lady in Waiting.
That's so awesome. And what's it mean? I mean, you are both residents of Larimer County, went to Cheyenne High Schools. What's it mean to represent?
It's huge. You know, we are the world's largest outdoor rodeo, and to get to represent, especially both of us having our dual citizenship to different countries, it's different, but it's awesome to be able to reach out to those other countries too and show them the daddy of them all.
Oh, definitely. Got a little nickname for yourselves. What is that?
Our general chairman likes to call us the International Court.
The International Court, I like that. That's fancy. One thing that's very important with Miss Frontier Lady in Waiting, the wave and the smile. So we're going to have you pull that off right now in unison. Go.
Ready? Elbow, elbow, wrist, wrist, wipe a tear, blow a kiss.
That was perfect. That was beautiful, ladies. finally tonight, I'm joined by the big man of CFD, Rod Hoddle. Rod, a lot of changes in 2012, especially here in the Gulch. That's the first thing I want to touch on. What's going to be different this year?
Well, you know, we did a lot of consumer research the last couple years, and our consumers were looking for some things to do that were more family oriented. So as you can see in the background here, we have a brand new barn, and to the north of that barn will be a petting zoo this year. We have a couple pads on down further in the Gulch that we'll have food vendors up against. So, you know, if you're disabled and you want to go up, you can roll on the concrete and order your food and be able to get that. Then you can see the new restroom facility down there in the background. So those porta pots will be gone this year.
Awesome. That's what people are excited for. That's what I like to hear.
So that'll be new to the Gulch this year. And then just to the north of that, we're putting in a Pee Wee Stampede rodeo. So that's a stick rodeo for the kids. There'll be three performances over there.
Oh, that's
the
awesome.
Kids can come, they'll get back numbers, they'll compete on stick horses and bulls and such.
So it's pretty much a all action rodeo with stick horses and stuff.
It is.
Very entertaining for the adults, gotta add that. On top of that, the carnival, you guys are doubling it. Now, I thought it was big to begin with, but now you're expanding the Lot A, doubling it. What's that mean?
Well, you know, last year the committee looked at the carnival and how we could expand it. Our consumer, again, you know, was looking for an expansion and growth in the carnival area. So we looked to that lot just to the south of the carnival. It used to be called A Lot, and we're going to expand the carnival into that lot this year. They're bringing the drop tower, and there's going to be a lot of new rides, attractions with the space, too. There'll be locations throughout the midway and stuff for rest areas and places that parents can sit and watch the kids ride. So we're looking really forward to an expanded carnival this year, and we think it's going to add a lot to the show.
Everything's just bigger and better this year. It seems like there is so much change, and you guys have changed so much listening to those outreach groups telling you what to change. So how do you feel coming into 2012?
You know, we feel really good coming into 2012. We had a great year last year, and you know, our volunteer force and our staff worked hard last year, and it was profitable. And what's great is we're putting those profits back into our park, upgrading some things on the park, taking care of some infrastructure issues. But you know, it's going to be better, and it's great to see improvements out here at Frontier Park, and we hope our consumer enjoys it.
It's going to be all around awesome. It's beautiful, Gulch. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us on
the
show.
You.
Have fun this year, because that's the most important thing. Well, that's all the time I have for the show this year. Sorry about that. But remember, Cheyenne Frontier Days, July 20th to the 29th. Tons going on. Come more than one day. It's definitely worth it. Until next year.
This has been an inside look at Cheyenne Frontier Days, sponsored by Boot Barn and Halliday Motors.
This might take more than one take. But stay tuned. This is going to be the end of the show, isn't it? It's the end of the show.
Wait.
We'll just look at this camera. It's completely silent now. Good smile, maybe a little wink. Until next year. Kick! Is this a girl's hat?
No, it's
not. Okay. Had a lot of people ask. Yep. Man, this is gonna be bad. Into the wild! My coworker got the same hat and I didn't even know it, and she was like, it's a girl's hat, you can't have that hat, because we're both sports and now we got the same hat. I don't think I'm riding off anywhere.